I'm Doug Larson with the Barbell Shrug Podcast. This is Technique Wad. If you want to get more Technique Wad videos, you can go to barbellshrug.com. We have videos on Olympic weightlifting, gymnastics, kettlebell stuff, on and on and on. So again, you can go to barbellshrug.com, go to Technique Wad, and we have hundreds of videos on pretty much any and all types of functional exercise. Today we're going to talk about pose running and how it's very similar to sprinting, which is something that I don't see people talk about very often, but is always kind of how I've thought of it, because I grew up doing basically only sprinting, and we never jogged at all. I was very fortunate to have a strength coach more or less my whole life, and we did pretty much all high-intensity interval type stuff and ran lots of sprints. We didn't do a lot of long-distance training. It was all very similar to how we train right now. It's lots of cleans and snatches and full-speed sprints. So today, I want to make that comparison between pose running and sprinting. So generally, how people think about running is that there was the old way of running where your heel striking and you wear big fluffy shoes with big padded heels, and you could heel strike without hurting your heels, and that led to a lot of injuries and a lot of problems. And everyone's kind of getting away from that now, and they're getting into the pose running barefoot model, where you're not heel striking anymore, you're landing on your midfoot, your heel kind of barely kisses the ground, and then you take your next step. So the pose method has been popular because with a lot of high volume running communities, there's lots of chronic overuse type injuries. There's a lot of knee pain, a lot of patellofemoral pain, and a whole host of other stuff too. So in an effort to eliminate that, people are moving towards the pose method of running, where if I'm running, instead of landing on my heel, I'm now landing with my foot right underneath me, and I'm landing midfoot just like this. And the benefit of that is that I'm not applying a braking force to my momentum. So if I apply if I heel strike with my foot right out in front of me, well, now my center mass is back here, my base support is out in front of me, and I apply some amount of braking to my running. I'm decelerating, at least just for a moment, I decelerate. So one of two things has to happen. Either I have to keep my legs straight, and now my center mass will raise as I kind of go over that big kickstand, or I'll break here, my knee will collapse, and I'll absorb all those forces and then push back off, which is usually what happens. So generally in sports, what happens is deceleration and change of direction have the highest spikes as far as maximum force. So I'm decelerating when I block out in front of me, and it puts a big force spike up through my whole body, and especially my knee absorbs the majority of those forces, and that's where people tend to get patellofemoral pain and they get hip issues and even low back issues. So those high force spikes tend to be what over time tends to give you achy joints. And people don't want achy joints, and so now with the pose method, it's a little different, where I'm leaning forward and that kind of makes me take a step, and then when I land midfoot, and that adds a joint. I'm not just landing on my heel where my knee and my hip are absorbing the majority of the forces. Well, now my ankle can help absorb some of those forces too. So really, rather than two joints absorbing the force, if we oversimplify this, now it's three joints absorbing the forces. Those forces are more equally distributed, and so the force spike at each joint individually isn't as high. You can do more volume before your joints break down. When people first start doing pose running, they notice that they get the bottom of their feet very sore. They notice that their calves get very sore, because now, since I'm on the ball of my feet, I'm getting a big calf contraction. All these muscles on the back of my leg are contracting, and they're absorbing some of the forces, and that's why they get sore. Just like any other resistance training that we do, if you do a lot of volume, your muscles get sore, they break down, and then they hurt for a couple days, you recover and rest, and then since they're very vascular, they have a lot of blood flow, they're going to deliver new nutrients, get rid of the old waste and the dead tissue, and they're recovered in no time. Okay, so that's a good thing. When you're pose running, you're absorbing a lot more of those forces at the ankle and on your calves and whatnot, and you're not absorbing them on the soft tissue or the passive structures in your knees, your cartilage, your ligaments, and things like that, because those tissues don't tend to heal as quickly. So you break them down, they don't heal, and then eventually they tear for good, and then you have knee surgery or whatever. Nobody wants that. Okay, so what do we do about our technique? How do we change it? Again, I'm going to talk about pose running in relation to sprinting. So first, basics on pose running. Again, I'm landing right underneath my body, on the ball of my heel, and then my heel will barely kiss the ground. And then I want to go back to this figure four position is what Brian McKenzie talks about. So basically the position we're in is this figure four position, and I'm kind of just switching and then switching and then switching from figure four to figure four to figure four, and I'm leaning forward while I'm doing it. So if I lean forward, I'm basically going from figure four position to figure four position to figure four position, and all I'm really thinking about is pulling my foot off the ground. Okay? You don't have to think about much else, just pull your foot off the ground as fast as you can, keep leaning forward with good posture, and that's kind of the basics of pose running. So if you want to oversimplify it and just think about one thing, just think about keep your posture, lean forward a little bit, and keep pulling your foot off the ground as quickly as possible. The less time you spend on the ground, the better. Huh? The other three things with regard to sprinting that we want to think about: posture, arm action, and leg action. So we're going to go in that order. Posture, again from Brian McKenzie of CrossFit Endurance. We podcasted with him on episode 82, I believe. Fantastic podcast, great guy, very entertaining. Knows his shit when it comes to endurance training. So go buy his book, Speed, Power, and Endurance. It's a fantastic book and very easy to read. He breaks it down where anyone, regardless of the background, can read it and get something out of it. So go buy that book, it's awesome. Posture-wise, what Brian recommends is taking your fingers and going just like this. You're going to put your pinky and your thumb flat on your chest, and then wherever your finger extends to is where you want your chin to be. If you have a round upper back and you're slumping over with that computer posture, just like you would be sitting at a desk and you're staring at the screen, okay, you're not going to be in that good position. So you want to have your pinky and your thumb just like this, and your finger touches your chin just like that. So that's your upper body. Your upper body, good posture, shoulders back like this, ribs down where I'm not overextended like that, ribs down. So that's, you know, good posture when you're standing. And we're basically just trying to keep that good posture as we're switching from foot to foot. Say what? Oh yeah, yeah. Thank you. I always forget about that. Okay. So we're, with regard to posture, that's how you're gonna stand. For us with sprinting, we wanna think about another thing, which is we're focusing on a point in the distance that we call that a focal point. Basically, it's a point on the horizon, which is right where the sky kind of comes down and meets the ground. It's a point way off in the distance. We're going to focus right at that point, and that's going to keep us looking straight ahead. That way we're not staring at the ground in front of us. We're not looking up in the air. We're just looking straight ahead, right where we're going to. If you're running distance, it's good to have a spot. That way you can just like pick, I'm running to that tree, and then I'm running to that building, and then you can just pick small little destinations on your way to your final destination. So having a focal point will come in key when we talk about leg action, but for now, just pick a point off in the distance, and that's exactly where you're gonna look. That way you can keep that neutral neck the entire time, okay? The next thing is arm action. For the most part, we wanna have our elbows sucked in to our side. Our hands are nice and relaxed like this. I'm just gonna take these two fingers and put them together. I'm not making a fist. Some people are too tense when they're sprinting, especially because they're trying to run full speed. So hands like this, nice and loose, elbows to the side, and our arms are gonna go cheek to cheek. So this cheek, and then switch cheek to cheek as we sprint, okay? You see a lot of people, they're shuffling side to side like this way too much. It's inefficient to go side to side when we're trying just to go forward. So everything should be forward and back focused, no side to side shuffling, okay? So for the most part, that's our arm action. For the record, that's called squeeze. We squeeze our elbows to our side when we're going cheek to cheek with our hands, okay? So that's the second thing, arm action. Third thing is leg action and leg drive. Part of the reason that people don't like the heel striking also is that a lot of times people strike with their toe out, and then they kind of roll over where their foot goes that way and their knee goes in, and it looks just like bad squatting like that. It's horrible. It twists your knee. That's how people get ACL tears and medial meniscus issues and knee pain in general, or one way they get knee pain in general rather. So if you have bad ankle mobility, you have poor hip strength, or just bad motor control because you don't know what technique is good technique and you have bad ingrained motor patterns from your past, then I want you to think about, again, foot straight ahead, landing right underneath your body on the ball of your foot. Never heel striking with your foot out like that, okay? So we don't want to run like this. We're not a duck. We want to have our feet straight ahead the entire time, Okay. So for leg action, that's one thing. Never toe out, always feet straight ahead. Number two, we talked about the figure four position. So we're always trying to get back into this position where I'm making the number four with both my legs. Generally, the faster you're running, if I'm jogging and I'm just doing pose, if I'm jogging slow, my figure four position will probably be about right here. If I'm jogging a little faster, I'll probably be a little bit higher. And if I'm running full speed sprints, I'll probably be up here like this. I'll come through, I'll hit here, I'll cycle through, and I'll come through, I'll hit here, and I'll cycle through, and I'll have that leg action the entire time. We call that wheel, okay? So if someone, for whatever reason, they're not cycling through very well, that's the cue we'll give them, is wheel. Even though I don't use that cue very often, that's what I call it. Knee drive, a part of wheel is knee drive, excuse me. So we have our focal point off in the distance. As I extend here, my knee should drive right towards my focal point, and then I can cycle back through. Come through, right to my focal point, and cycle back through. Again, always landing right underneath my body. If you're running full speed sprints, it'll probably happen automatically. So for that reason, I like to have people that are trying to learn how to pose run do more sprinting. More full speed sprinting will make it where you can learn how to pose run almost automatically. It wasn't a weird thing for me to learn how to pose run. They said, just, you know, the first time I ever did it, someone said, it's like this. And I said, oh, it's just like sprinting. And they said, oh, I don't know, I've never sprinted before. And I said, oh, well, with sprinting, you do this. They said, oh yeah, do it like that. And I said, okay, I'll just do what I've been doing, basically, okay? So run more full speed sprints, and it will help you with your pose running technique. So if you want to drill your sprinting technique, we're gonna use those three categories, posture, arms, and legs, and we're gonna do a series of 20 or 30 yard sprints running maybe 80 to 90% full speed, okay? You wanna run fast, but you wanna be very relaxed. So what I like to do is run, you know, 30 yards and then walk back. Run 30 yards and then walk back. Very similar to doing, you know, drills with a PVC pipe when you're trying to learn how to snatch. You're not trying to get tired, or maybe use just the barbell when you're learning how to snatch. You're not trying to get tired. You're trying to drill a perfect movement pattern. And so if you're trying to relearn how to run, then you have to do, you know, perfect technique sets. Not to fatigue, you're not trying to get faster, you're not trying to get tired, you're trying to just improve your technique. So today, to do that, what I suggest is doing, you know, maybe three sprints where you're focusing on your posture. All you're thinking about is keeping a neutral neck, shoulders back, nice and tall, ribs down, and you're sprinting just thinking about your posture. Run a couple of those, again, 30 yards down, and then just walk back. And then you can do the same thing for your arm action. You're gonna run 30 yard sprints, maybe three of them, sprint down, walk back. This time though, you're thinking about nice, loose, relaxed hand position where your first two fingers are together here, your thumb and your pointer finger, keeping your hands relaxed. Your elbows are in, shoulders are back, and you're going cheek to cheek. And for those three sprints, you're just thinking about your arm action. You're not thinking about your posture, you're not thinking about your legs, thinking about your arm action only. Never shuffling side to side, okay? Do three sprints like that, and then do three more sprints, and this time you're thinking about your leg drive. You're thinking about having your feet straight ahead. You're thinking about driving your knee right to your focal point, landing right underneath your body, pushing off and not flying open with your leg. Okay? Everything straight ahead. You're coming through, landing, and you're coming through, and you're landing. So you're only thinking about your feet. You're not thinking about your posture. You're not thinking about your arms. Again, never toeing out. Everything straight ahead. You're running that way, so there's no need to go side to side or point in any other direction except for forward and backward. Okay? Last point is, when I'm running those sprints, I tend to like to do what I call a toes up lean. And so I'm here, have good posture, elbows are in, I go up onto my toes and then I lean, and then I can start running from there. So you lean forward, and then right before you start to fall, you can start into your 80 or 90% full speed sprint. So that's the way I like to do it. Again, sprint down, walk back, not trying to get tired, okay? You're trying to work on your technique. So I hope that helps. Kind of a different take on it. Most of that was sprinting specific, but it does correlate very well to how to pose run as well. So hope it's a different take on it. I hope it helps. If you have more questions about running or sprinting, you can always go to barbellshrug.com, click the Ask a Question tab at the top of the page, and maybe we can do a technique wad or a daily BS on your question in the future. Thanks.